Now, if you just look at this pressure enthalpy diagram, we can see the again we'll see the process 1 to 2 is the isentropic compression, 2 to 3 is the condensation, 3 to 4 is the isentropic throttling, and 4 to 1 is the evaporation. So we will take the readings. Actually, we are supposed to take the readings. So there are different readings for pressure as well as temperature. So what is the to find out this plot, to find out these points like 1, 2, 2 dash, 3, you need to have the pressures as well as the enthalpy. So what we are doing, we are finding out the temperatures here and pressures. So pressure at compressor inlet, pressure at compressor outlet, pressure at the condenser outlet, pressure at the condenser inlet. So the pressure at the compressor outlet and the condenser outlet, they are almost same. That actually there are two pressures only. One is the evaporator pressure and second is the condenser pressure. So the evaporator pressure is a higher pressure, sorry, lower pressure, and the condenser pressure is a higher pressure. That is 290 bar, and here it is 25, not bar, sorry, it is pounds per square inch, PSI. So temperatures also will be measured at the compressor inlet, temperature at the compressor outlet, condenser outlet. These all temperatures will be measured, and then the energy meter is there. What is the revolutions of energy meter and the time taken by the energy meter, and the evaporator inlet temperature and the evaporator outlet temperatures are taken, and then the very simple theoretical COP is the refrigeration effect, that is H1 minus H4 divided by H2 minus H1. These are the enthalpies. Okay, refrigeration effect is H1 minus H4, and this compressor H2 minus H1 is a compressor one. So from the pressure enthalpy diagram of the Freon 12, what we have seen, you get the values as like H1 is 215 kilojoules per kg, H2 is 240, H4 is 175. So that substituting these values, we will get the value of theoretical COP as 1.5. And if you take the actual readings and then calculate the COP, you will get it as slightly low actually. You should get, this is wrong, you should get something lower. Theoretical COP should be high, actual COP should be low, and then the relative COP is the ratio of actual divided by theoretical, so you get something as 0.9. So the COP, coefficient of performance of vapor operation compression system, which is varies from somewhere to 2 to 5, that is the ratio of that is a coefficient COP of vapor compression refrigeration system. That you should know. It varies from somewhere between 2 to 5. Okay, the best being 5 and the least being 2. And you have got the pH diagram, what I was showing in my presentation. So here you can see the diagram of the pressure enthalpy diagram. So you can find out all this. I think this is not very clear as such, but you should be used to finding out this. Like this is for R12 refrigerant. Every refrigerant has its own pH diagram. So this line represents the saturated liquid line. This is where the x is equal to 0, and this is the saturated vapor line where x is equal to 1, and in between is a mixed region, that is wet vapor. So this was about the vapor compression refrigeration system performance evaluation, and to find out the performance, you need to have this test rig with the temperature and pressure recording devices with the energy meter, so that you can find out the performance. So I hope this suffices, and you will practice this when you come to the laboratory, so that you will have better hands-on experience. Thank you.